Jan, when we did Drag City, Jan took the, it was either Drag City or Honolulu. It was the middle of the night. We mixed it and we went to the, we went down to the mastering room and cut an acetate, 45 acetate. And we drove in his Stingray up to Hollywood Boulevard and he went upstairs to KFWB. And Roger Christian put the song on the radio while we sat down in the car and listened to it to see if it sounded good on the radio. Can you imagine being able to do that? You couldn't, there's no way you could do that now.
Alley-oop, I think we recorded it at night. Yeah, and we had the next day we'd go to the coffee shop below KFWB and the jocks would be in there.
Yeah, if the program director happened to like the record, you were in. That was the formula of the day, which made it exciting because...
It was instant. You know, you could think of the song, call the musicians, get into the studio, and within a week or so, you know if you had a hit or not.
Oh, I mean, we would do a session at 8 in the morning, and by 5, it was number 2 in Oxnard.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. I remember one time Jimmy Bowen called everybody to do a session. I think it was at midnight or 1 o'clock in the morning, because he knew that everybody was working till 11 or 12. And so we went down to United Recorders, and he had... meticulously hired everybody who had played on Neil Hefti's Batman.
He was going to do a cover record, right?
And he was going to do a cover, so we did. We faked it. I mean, there was no music or anything. Jeez. All the guys that had just done Neil Hefti's date tried to remember what each one of us had played. And he said, now you guys are going to hear this on the radio at 6 o'clock this morning if you're still on your way home. And sure enough, you turned on the radio, and he had gotten acetates over to various disc jockeys who at the time were into playing things as quick as they could.
So fast.
It was so fast. It was unreal.
12 sites, 3 days. That's from downbeat to mix. And at that time, you had to mix stereo, and you had to mix monaural also.
They run it up. I can't tell you how many times you give the guy $20 like this, and he put it on the air, and maybe it was more than that, and no problem. If that was a big record, I remember I finished a record with Lou Adler, who I always thought was a really fine producer, and we finished this record at 2:30 in the morning, and my wife and I had just bought a house in the valley, up Alameda Avenue. And they were still building up there. And I had worked all day and night on this thing. And I was driving up like this. I rolled the window down to go into the garage. I heard the record. They were blasting it over the PA system while they were building the houses up there. I said, where am I? I can't imagine. What the heck is going on? Obviously, he had taken it to the record station, and they played it on the radio at 4 or 5 o'clock, whatever, 6 o'clock in the morning, whatever it was.